Hello everyone, welcome back to Naturally Gamers. I am Bray, and we are continuing on with Omensight.
And that one with you. Yeah. Interesting.
So you know who this is?
I'm just surprised to see you here. I know the fighting's not over yet.
Something urgent came up. Look, I know you keep tabs on everyone. Where is Ludomir?
Ludomir?
We need something from him.
Unless you can travel back in time, you're out of luck. He's now a pile of steaming ash. Hendrix work, of course.
That's inconvenient. Theodore?
Yes?
Why do you keep looking at the clock?
Oh, I'm waiting for someone.
Only Vera and the one she trusts with her life, Ludomir, have the key to Vera's personal seal. In Rodentia, a passage to an amber tree is locked by Vera's seal. It leads to Vera's secret hideout. In a secret hideout in Rodentia, inside a sealed amber tree, Vera met with a treacherous group of Rodentians. I cannot pronounce that word to save my life. The next person we should go back in time with is Ludomir, since he should be able to open up those doors.
Show good composure, Harbinger. I would have killed that treacherous Fjobor on sight. Now, Ludomir, what will it take for him to teach you how to unlock the seal? You should take a look at what you have learned so far.
Pray for your success, Harbinger.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, crap. Wait, is this replaying everything or?
Ratika. She fooled me into believing she was a good person.
Made a bad decision.
I still remember the day she showed up with Vera. Ratika had the notion that orphan owls should live with bears. To death, Ratika must die.
Oh. I know what I have to do. I have to kill Ratika this time around.
Ludomir, you're too early. My hair is still a mess.
Save your wits for someone who cares.
So, you're not here to...
I guess...
Enough! You know exactly why I'm here.
Hold on. It's complicated, all right?
What I don't understand.
Listen to me. I can explain everything.
We've been through all this. Let's just get to the fight.
I had to do it, and it was for... Never mind. Ludomir, I get, but you? Why do you want me dead? Never mind. You picked on the wrong Rodentian.
Time
for some, strategic redeployment. Skip. Hold on.
What I?
Listen.
No, save.
But I had to do it, and it was just... Never mind. Never mind.
Careful. Those matches want something.
Ouch! Stop it! You can't hurt me if you can't reach me.
She would want you to be there, I think.
show me how to open up those magic doors, please?
Argentina's biggest hope. Well, smallest hope of victory. With a bit of luck, nobody knows Radica's dead yet.
They probably already know then.
Useful.
Oh, okay.
Shadow boxing is useless. Let's go bash some real skulls.
Okay, how did you get across? Did I have the sword? Thank you, kind sir, I think. And I, of course, missed that jump. Oh, come on now. Of course. jumping is the absolute bane of my existence. Ooh, made it. Can you open the door?
Centuries, and she only taught one person the way to unlock it.
And now, another person in the locket. A grove in the old forest locked by a personal seal bearing the sigil of Vera, the godless priestess. Comprehension surges into your mind. You have learned how to unlock Vera's seals.
Did you just learn the seal ritual?
Yes,
it took me months! Anyway, this was our secret place, Vera and mine.
Whoa. That takes off health. Don't touch that. Rudimere is knee deep in the river, miserably failing at catching a fish. She would rather be fighting. He would rather be winning prizes like his father, but Mum says fighting is good, but not starving is better. Ah, only he has siblings. He bought the crowd. Have them to all the fishes. Rudimere's mind begins to wander. If the river ends at the edge of the world and the water falls, how come he never dries out? Maybe we should explore the edge of the world one day, even have his own airship. A frozen sensation brings Rudimere back to reality. Cold. He's been in the water for so long, he lets out a deep sigh. Focus on the fish, now stand still, then they come closer, and grab. He fails. Again. He hates fishing. Sounds like my jumping. I hate jumping. Anger builds up. In frustration, Rudimere smashes the water, making a huge splash. He sinks it quickly. On the river's bank, a fish is awash. Brought there by displaced water, he grabs. How about that, man? Rudimere returns home, proudly holding his catch. As soon as he opens his door, there's another grass and another Anna pulls him aside. A grave look in her face. Come, we have guests. She does not even acknowledge the fish. Mom knows how. In the main hall, two figures are standing, covered in dirt. One is Radica, the other, Rudimere does not recognize, but surprisingly, it's Vera the rat. But another addresses the guests, gesturing at Rudimere. She doesn't know yet. Okay.
Dear to me as if she were blood. We were close when we were growing up. Then we just drifted apart, and I failed her when she needed me most. The vengeful spirit you sent me has accomplished its mission, little sister. That's what you wanted, right? Peace.
She wants rule.
What are you saying?
To show me that door.
Not a piece? Sword? That sword? What do you mean, too late?
How do you talk to ghosts with me? Vera's spirit can communicate with me. She spoke to him about a sword. Vera is buried in Rodentia. Access to a grave is held by a powerful seal. You have a quiet key to Vera's personal seal in the room. Guided by Vera's spirit, Rudimere found her dead body hidden in the secrets. Okay. Whoa. Okay.
Voden saw you. This is not supposed to be. Had I waited a moment longer, next time I will act swifter. You are safe now, at least.
Oh dear.
That seal you learned from Ludomir. It is the same seal protecting Vera's hideout. You can return there with Radica and see this proof she is so insistent about.
Okay.
So it begins. Another chance to save Euralia.
Saving the world?
No, I cannot. Because that would mean to end the day. Various transgressions of war, Omensight acquired.
Look at this!
the goalie right there. In a secret hideout on the ship, Vera has unleashed the boys. She's surrounded by several accomplices, both Jinshin and Vera. Radica did not kill Vera. Vera was after the legendary Zord Kladin and uncovered its location from the mirrors in the forbidden crypt, but once inside the vault, Radica betrayed and stabbed the princess. Unbeknownst to Radica, Vera survived her wounds, aided by unknown accomplices. In a secret hideout on the danger, inside an amber tree, Bear and her accomplices summon the boy at a ritual and fall in the sword. Kladin.
I can't bring you home. Something is fighting me.
It's like the giant snake from God of War.
The breach, but I doubt we are safe. Odin is likely to be gathering his strength for another attack. You must hurry. Oh, how wrong I was. If the priestess is in league with the void, with Odin, then all is lost. Perhaps we have no choice but to abandon this world to its fate.
Should offer your anger to
me. Yes, yes, thank you. Why not? can be a path. Should I go back to Radica? I'll do the mirror. Bullet? I don't have anything to say to me. Okay. I'm thinking. It's either Radica or Indrik. Since he needs the sword. Well. Let's try Indrik. Yes.
Go, Harbinger. I will be watching over you.
The godless priestess to such madness. I push my subjects, yes. But that's because I can see beyond their potential, even past their breaking. Did I push her to this madness as well? I cannot do this. Ending the war will mean the retentions have no cause to unleash the void. Let us find Radica.
Retentions! There's no need for violence!
Don't let him mess with your mind, brothers!
Now's our chance!
Take what you need.
Fighting at once! intentions to listen.
Okay. So. Can I go back? Yep.
Still be fighting each other.
The void seeping through the walls. Or is it your presence, Harbinger, that grants me this awareness?
Okay. Footfalls make Endrick blink and glance at that solitary room as Vincent tells him to hide the church treasure. But his bones are gift overpowers him. At any given second, his patrician could target the door and demand it from Endrick. Look then, stripped in every sense of love. But this gift, this ant bone sent by his parents in secret, is a treasure from childhood. Endrick glides his hand along the glass, tracing the worker ant's path. Even as a young boy, Endrick had been fascinated with nature on a surprisingly small and musical scale. He was at it again now, but this time, his awe had to be kept secret. The hour hits his twilight, but still Endrick observes the colony noting its findings by scrawling comparisons of its attachment. Exhaustion moves. Swiftly and without warning, Endrick falls asleep, and the ant bone moves out in the open and dangerous sky. Sometime later, Endrick's body eyes open and the patrician is there, grass blowing in his senior's face. One foot motion woke and snatches the colony and throws it. Glass hits stones and shattered pieces, litter the ground. Standing opposite Endrick, the patrician pauses, motionless, expressionless. Unnaturally calling the entry that Endrick once held for a from his control and discipline eviscerates as he sees the ants skitter across the floor. Something fractures within Endrick. A realization takes hold. Endrick will not be like his insect friends. He will not run or hide. Instead, he will become like regret. He will become a predator. Okay. Now to get back.
your leader.
Stop toying with us and get it over with. If you can reach us. Ha!
Please, I just got married.
Step aside.
You can throw fireballs, but you can't do anything else. Why is this here?
Use of amber.
Credentials. You are free to go. I only wish to speak with your leader.
Yeah, and as soon as we move, your soldiers will turn us into practice dummies.
Then, leave the prison at once. Any who harms a Redention will be court-martialed. Now, move! Stand down, Redentions. No harm will come to you. You have my word.
All right. How do I get that? Don't know.
Let me help.
I'm looking off. Because I can. Oh, you're the best. You're the best, Sandra. You really are.
Harbinger, you must use your power. Show Ratika the vision. Expect as much disbelief from her as from herself.
Hmm.
not here for tea.
Never know. It was damn good tea.
My companion has something urgent to show me.
Is that the... Show me what, exactly?
Harbinger, use your power. Show Ratigan what you showed me.
No thanks. No offense, Harbinger. You do look like the real deal, but I can't trust you for siding with Indrik here.
Ratigan, people can change. I realize what I've done. The different directions I might have taken.
Different directions? Are you kidding? Oh, you've gone far beyond the point of no return.
Ratigan, please listen. I'm not here to fight. You and I, we face a greater enemy.
Indrik, I don't know what to say. Here you are, fake Harbinger and all, asking for help. After
can I
all
just
the damage you've
use
done,
my Omensight on you?
If you're gonna lie, you you'll need to lie this. A lot better than this. This is just embarrassing.
Harbinger, okay. Hurry! The vision!
Very
little how she died. This is random in the background.
The harm is done.
Oh, that's too much.
You've not failed in your attempt.
Well, yeah. They don't teach us owl anatomy at school. Oh, God. I don't have to justify myself to you. You think you're so perfect, Emperor? You've done far worse than me. Murder, torture, war.
And
you think you'll ever find redemption?
Have
not like
just quite.
You think you're so perfect, Emperor? Done far worse than me.
Oh.
Murder, torture, war. And you think you'll ever find redemption? Not likely.
Okay.
You are right.
What?
I have harmed
that?
Many in trying to bring our nations together, including you, Ratigan. And for that, I am sorry. But now is not the time to blame. Now we need to act.
What was that? Indrik, what happened to you? Wait, why am I acting all flustered? You're the one who should be flustered. You know what? Never mind. Indrik, if you're serious, I'll give you one chance to explain. One chance.